Mboy bu ne dehe mom la Seereer ganon fonk ndax ku ñom Seereer de du jeex tak nga le non non de nga joge chambre A dem chambre B deng joge chambre A nga dem chambre B bo defé rit yi ki nga bayyi sa ginaaw ma A man nga jokk ak mom di waxtaan ak mom moy tu ci de Seereer dañu ané nit ki deewul dafa tukki motax muy wax de dafa am way yu bari yon ci rew korupa hole rogole korupa waju bax wo nañ ko yalla moko wo janombal nomele rogonome janombal bijinu xarbi lemul bopam yalla mokal man bakkan du rey bopam mais yalla mo lay soxla ne kay Gayose gayena gen malola gayose gayena malola ne gasel bi de danuna morom mom ya nga joy moy ku deg ma hon wa jalwa nyowa lola hon wa jalwa nyowa alola ne ñi de ñu nga bek re fañu dem way ñi dund ñu ngi joy di mitilu lolu maraya wa gut bay maraya maraya ba gut bay maraya maraya ya gut bay maraya yaay xone kara yaay xone kar foy dem yaay gut bay foy dem ne sama yaay defa tukki gan la won fi dafa ñibi gan la won fi dafa ñibi alors ben jani ñu jappade ne du destruction totale mais un changement d'état joge ci li dem ci la motax rit yi Seereer don def yeb do Seereer dej la ganon fonk fekke ne comme les pharaons bu nit ki de dañu reey nak bu mak yakare yakandal ci begu keer gi malam bo nekke jegim o xafar tuma farfarok sen farfarok e mbolo bu tolni amul ken ku kuma ci jappale kuma faral yalla rek la faral kok moy wa ciaw ñi sante ciaw
Hello, my name is Tamsier Joof, and I'm sending my warmest regards and greetings to the Seereer community, the Senegambian community, and African and African diaspora, wherever you are. As many of you know, we lost our dear uncle, friend, and colleague, Professor Issa Laye Thiaw. Mani Kau asked for how to call his Seereer name, as he once told me. And that was in, we lost him in on the 10th of September 2017, and this year marks the third anniversary since his death. And as such, we all decided to come together and pay homage or tribute to that great man who have done so much in the documentation and preservation of Seereer history, culture, and traditions, and trying to document our stories through the pages of history. I first came to know of Professor Issa Laye Thiaw mainly through his writings. And through my own line of work with the Seereer Resource Centre, which I founded in 2008. And as many of you know, the Seereer Resource Centre's main objectives are to document, preserve, and disseminate materials relating to Seereer history, culture, and tradition, including traditional Seereer religion or spirituality, the spiritual beliefs of our ancestors, which are fundamental in how to call it for our culture. And it was through my work with the SRC, the Seereer Resource Centre, that I came to know of him, mainly his writings. And a few years after that, a few years after 2008, we're talking about probably 2009 or 2010 or 12 or something like that, I came upon an article that was authored by the Senegambian author and scholar called Fatou Camara. Now, in that article, I believe she did an interview with Professor Thiaw, and where Professor Thiaw discoursed about setting up a sort of an institute called the Temple of Initiated Women. And the purpose of that institute was it would be like a place, a sort of a school where anyone interested in Seereer history, culture, and traditional Seereer medicine and so forth can come and learn about the Seereer culture. So that learn about the culture, history, and so forth. Then once they finish, they can go back. So there will be a campus within the school where people can live until hardcore they finish and graduated. When I first read that, I said, wow, this is an amazing idea because we really need that. So since then, I've tried to, since I've read that article, I said, well, I need to contact this gentleman to see how we can offer our services to Hartico to help bring that project to fruition. Unfortunately, I couldn't get any, I couldn't get his contact details, so despite trying numerous avenues. And I said, well, let me just leave that idea behind and just concentrate on working with the Seereer Resource Centre. So few years after, in 2013, we set up the Seereer Resource Centre website. As I was explaining earlier, the organization itself was founded in 2008. However, the website was not officially launched until 2013, which was a couple of years after. And in the website itself, we had a feature, we had a forum where any registered member can come and hardcore hold discussions on matters relating to Seereer history, culture, and traditions. Anything you had to go like you don't have to be Seereer, anyone hardcore who's registered. And one of these a gentleman by the name of Dembasen also registered 2013, July 2013, which was the hardcore the month and year that I've the website was launched. Dembasen registered. And how to call it, through our discussions, him and I, we became very, very close friends. And how to call it, we started how to call it, like, well, I can see Dembasen is not just my friend and a colleague, like many of you know, he's an integral member of the Seereer Resource Centre team. And he's not just a friend of mine or a colleague, but obviously I can say, I can probably claim that he is a family member. He's a member of my family. So in one of those discussions, article online discourse, I believe it was emails and article through emails and article social media and telephone calls, the Professor Thiaw's name came up where Demba told me that he knew he knows Professor Thiaw. I said, are you kidding me? You know who Professor Thiaw is? He said, yes, of course I know him. He's my uncle. And hardly, I sometimes help him out with typing his documents and hardly printing, doing some printing for him or whatever he requires of me. I help him out, and I was actually at his house only a few days ago. I say, wow, that's amazing. For several years, I've been trying to contact Professor Thiaw to see how we can offer our services to help bring that project that I've read many years ago about the Temple of Initiated Women project that he wanted to implement. I say, what I'm going to do, I was supposed to go to Senegal anyway, because I was supposed to go to Gambia, then afterwards go to Senegal, as I always do. Every time I go to Gambia, I have to go to Senegal to go and interview some elders relating to on matters relating to Seereer history, culture, and tradition, so that we can document them for the work that we do at the SRC. I said, what I'm going to do, I'm going to bring that article, my visit forward, actually. So I'm going to actually go to Senegal much earlier than I originally planned. So when I go down, when I come down there, we can all go together and article go and interview him. And of course, as many of as I was saying in Wolof, every time I go to Demba's, every time I go to Senegal, I spend my time at Demba's house. He's the one who plays host, and every time he comes to Gambia, I'm the one who plays host. He stays at my house. And Hatukoli, that's how close we are. That's how he's like a family now. So anyway, Hatukoli, I said, okay, that's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to come to Senegal and we'll all go together and interview him. So in December 2014, January 2015, I went to Gambia and proceeded to go to Senegal. And on the 8th of January, that was the first day that I've laid eyes on Professor Issa Laye Thiaw, where I had to go, I went to interview him with Dembasen. This man was the most amazing man, had to call it, anyone could wish to meet. He was so generous with his time and knowledge, and had to call it, because he understood why we were there. He understood the importance of our job, and hardcore, he was so welcoming and so hardcore, such a secret, such an amazing host. And hardcore, like, you know, he gave us so much material that day It was so much the article, like we had to, if when I actually launched the Seereer Radio website, with the Seereer Radio article project in 2016, I had and played that article, document, that audio, that interview that we did with him. We had to divide it into two parts, part one and part two, that many of you probably heard. And the article, like, article when it was broadcast on Seereer Radio. And Professor Issa Laye Thiaw was the kind of person who was extremely generous with his time and knowledge. And not only did he regarded me as his son, and I regarded him as an uncle of mine. And on that day, we did a lot of hard to call. We spent hours and hours and hours interviewing this great man. And at no point during that interview did he show any sign of discomfort or hard to call, like, despite the fact that we had to call, we spent hours and I was in hard to call interviewing him. We spent practically most of the day at his house. He was so amazing and hard to call, like, he understood why we were there. He understood the importance of our work at the SRC. And in fact, I will never forget, he told us numerous times, in fact, just because we didn't interview him once. That was not the only time that we interviewed him in 2015, but had to call it numerous times after that, as many of you heard. And when we played had to call it, his had to call it interviews on Seereer Radio, which I founded in 2016. And had to call it, on that day and the previous article, the previous interviews, and article here, I will always remember, he told us that what you are doing is very important. He understood why we were there. He understood why we were there. And he told us numerous times that Demba and I, that what you are doing is very, very important. However, he warned us that there would be a lot of people who would be against what we are doing because they do not want the truth to come out. However, the truth must come out. And as many of you probably, well, some of you might know, most of you probably wouldn't. Professor Thiaw was outside Senegalese establishment because actually he was actually writing about how to call it the preserve. He was documenting and preserving the traditional, not just the civil history and culture, but also the traditional spiritual beliefs of our ancestors, how our ancestors used to how to call it, practice their spiritual practice their spiritual life, go through their spiritual journey, their spiritual life. And how to call it, like, many people did not want that to come out because, as you know, Senegambia article is now a majority Muslim countries. They are majority Muslim article countries, Senegal and Gambia. So obviously, he was outside the establishment, and had to call, like, but he, as I was saying, that had to call, like, he despite the attempts of some people who wanted to silence him, to had to call, to prevent him from had to call, letting this kind of material come out, had to call, he warned us numerous times that there would be people who are against what we are doing because they do not want the truth to come out. However, the truth must come out. And as I've it's been many years since I founded the Seereer Resource Centre and had to go to the Seereer Radio. And in all those years, I have never asked any member of the community, a Seereer community, to particularly to contribute, to help us. Since 2008 or up till now, I've been funding the article, both the projects, the Seereer Resource Centre, the Seereer Radio, and so forth. And particularly, like, with my own finances, not for nothing, but also with the help of article, my, with my own finances, but had also having support from article, my presenters who have been very, very article helping, who have been very, very helpful in article, like, to volunteer their services. And article, like, it can be very, very tough to spend all those years putting your resources and your time and energy and effort on all that in these projects. And had to call it, like, us. Every time I want to give up, I always remember what he advised us. That had to call it, it's not gonna be an easy ride. you will make lots of enemies because there will be people who do not want the truth to come out, however the truth must come out. And every time I'm on the verge of giving up, I always remember that, and that gives me motivation to continue. And I'm very thankful for how to call it, the people that work with me, how to call it, especially my presenters on Seereer Radio, and including how to call it, just to name a few, Demba Sen, my colleague, and Momo Rafal, and the Musukoro CDB, Leite Sen, who is now the new director of programs at Seereer Radio, and how to call it, Joke Labangom, and you know, Musukoro CDB, Dudu Joof, and Lycan Jallo, Kabul Bass, and how to call it, like, you know, these people, these kind of people are dealing with me, and of course, how to call it, Lance Johnson, who is the more commonly known as Dimla Sen in the United States, and how to call it, these people have been with me, how to call it, since, you know, for quite a long time, and since the rough days, but how to call it, every time, just to get back to the point that I was making, every time I on the verge of how to call it, you know, say, you know what, let me just give up on this thing because this is far too much. This is too painful for me. Because article is spending years and years, over a decade, and article investing, and then you invest in your own personal financial resources, but also your time and the energy and effort and everything else that goes with it. It's not easy. But every time I'm on the verge of giving it up, I always remember the article, the advice he and the late Professor Thiaw told us, advised us. But actually, on that day, on the 8th of January 2015, when I went to his house to interview him with Demba Sen, and this man was so generous. I mean, actually, he brought out a huge, you know, he gave us a lot of material. We spent hours and hours down there and interviewing him, as you heard in one of in actually that when we played that interview on Seereer Radio, after. Then had to go, like, you know, the interview was so long, we had to divide it into two parts, part one and part two. The sheer length of that interview that we did with him in 2015, I think that was just an example of the generosity of the man. I mean, even during the interview, I told him numerous times, I say, uncle, come on, we have to stop this interview now because you've been imparting knowledge on us for several hours now. He was so determined, Hartikul said, nope, we have to continue. He was so determined because he understood why we were there and the importance. It was as if he wanted, he was rushing for time. It was as if he was rushing for time, and he wanted to let that knowledge come out. And that thing always goes through my mind. I always remember how to call it that day. But how to call it, he was such a general. He was such a kind man. He was such a kind natured man, a great host, and how to call it, amazing human being. And even after the following year, we went down to interview him again, and that was in 2016. And I was with my team, Demba Sen as usual, and I think also Njaga Gay and Mohamed Seka. Yeah, they were there. Yes, to interview him again. And during that interview, as usual, he was always being hardcore kind. And during the interview, I asked him about the Seereer Rampa script. Now, the Seereer Rampa script, as for many of you who do not know, was an ancient script, an ancient Seereer script that was used by the priestly class. Particularly, it was known by the priestly class. Some of the hardcore, the ordinary Seereers also used to be, especially the herders. They used to use it to mark on how to call it their cattle, just like a symbol, signs. But how to call it, it's that the script itself was mainly used by how to call it the priestly class, the Saltigis and stuff like that, and the ancient Lamans. For some of you who are not familiar with Seereer history, the ancient Seereer Lamans were the how to call it, Laman means in Seereer, the owner of the land, and they were like the kings and the land owners. And they were also responsible for how to call, like, you know, the priests, the how to call, they were the guardians of Seereer spirituality, Afarroh. And these kind of people, they knew how to call, how they have to get used to communicate with one another. So anyway, in that interview, I asked him about the Rampa script, because many of these kind of information has been lost. Now, I actually, anyway, how to call, I asked about the Rampa script. I will come to that point that I was going to make probably later on. So he said, well, just give me a minute. He went inside, he left us in the sitting room and went inside his room and brought out a huge bundle of documents. I was so astonished when I saw those documents, and when I went through them, I said, everything that you could imagine about or matters related to Seereer history, culture, tradition and spirituality, including the Rampa script, was there. I was so shocked. I said, Professor Thiaw, you got all this? You kept all this stuff? He said, of course I kept it. And I had to call it, anytime that you want to publish them, just come over. Now, we had this course with him about setting up a publishing house, a Seereer publishing house, which later became the Seereer Heritage Press. So anyway, he said to me, I had to call it, like, anytime that you are ready to come, just come over and just take them and just publish them. And I had to call it, like, you know, yeah, I mean, he was so generous. He was so kind. And I had to go, like, you know, after that interview, and had to go, like, you know, we said thank you very much. You know, we planned on going to visit Professor Mark, his elder cousin, Saltigi Birampui, who was a real Saltigi, a Seereer high priest, real Saltigi, gifted member of the Saltigi class. And particularly, he said, you want to go to see Saltigi Birampui tomorrow? Just come over and particularly, we will all go together. I said, come on, Professor Thiaw, you're going to be, you're already tired. We spent already hours and hours and hours interviewing you. And particularly, you must be particularly tired now. Come on, don't worry. We'll just take a taxi from Denver's house and just go to it. He said, no, just come over and we all go together. And particularly, Then we had, like, you know, we thanked him and said our goodbye. So the following morning, we left early. We left Dakar early and had to go to Jobas. And had to go on our way to had to go leaving Denver's house. We took a taxi and had to go. When we got to his Professor Chow's house to pick him up, he was outside outside the street, just waiting for us. So we took him and we went together to Jabaz. And just before we reached Jabaz, and had to call, he said to the driver, stop here. We stopped down there and had to call, we went to a huge field. It was like an empty field, empty plot of land. He said to me, do you know this? This all this land is mine. And had to call, like, you know, he said, all this land is mine, and had to, you know, when I want you, from his own mouth, I want to article you, when I want you to set up the Seereer Resource Centre here, and we're going to call it the Seereer Resource Centre and the Temple of Initiated Women. I was so shocked when he said that. That was article in the Demba could bear witness to that, and including some of my colleagues, article Demba, Jagagi, and Maud Seka. Some of you probably seen on the article on our the Seereer Resource Centre and Seereer Radio webs joint YouTube channel. Some of that material was uploaded there, but most of it weren't.
So this is the land property of Professor Issa Laye Thiaw, and he submitted to all Seereer in Senegal and in the diaspora, mm-hmm. So to set the project of Seereer Resource Centre. A project of Seereer Research Center and the Temple of Initiated Women. So he had left this land at our disposal. So in order to see some partners who are interested in to settle this project in order to keep and preserve Seereer culture. So this land, we hope that it will welcome a traditional Seereer village where Seereer medicine, Seereer religion and culture and all those things will be preserved in this. So it will be a village built in this old ancient Seereer village pattern. So we are calling to all people who are interested in this kind of project to join us and try to see how to succeed it.
When a record where you have taken Professor Issa Laye Thiaw, if he can have could just give us a bit more from his own words, what had to call it, he is planning to do here.
Malatta in em won tamsir ne ko merhay mi do et dutum prosenga dutum legay ina nga daral wahin ke ina ne e bo cine we savi savi na sayen ba raga won ngang di masbi usihan da o mini ajnenga watnenga da wakidik cina ne jahay poci hayre han kidik ki kadi poci hayre han bo rak di cale ne kidik jam cara cha tumonde da waay ni ke jiri yakang da safi ki di chame de pa yo finding haloy no finding gumbay na finding je je hawr ki di chem cha kadi po di je cha manna intire on nak safi rafna intem da habi cha da jaay ni ke ine na na wa hay bahde kul ha bahde chosan safi lo lo weta ki di king rang ga jen ngoy na hay di ape ki di gino nga wa cha wa wi waay mo se tombe wa habde ina yakang safi we what kidino was a mum wa paye inunik wa wane plato ponti wa paye inunik wa paye afel pek we very mum ji wane was a mum we don't fat ya banda we ban hab de hon wane kija apat pada mum tina kidik tijan we banga china ko eno ut ira kina gajuan paye we very de kumbanya ji do hotenye cey tak pangfi nak wa pang wa pa small wa ni ki na na wa pa ji ina lai wa ina na kun so ke so na so lai pang pi wa na pa ye da wa ni ri da wa man na ni hab tu ba ma do di wa wa ni ne fu so ke lai wa la fra ko sa hi man na prostat wa ane wa da wa pa ye pa ki ji wa pang wa te ko pa small te ko pa small wa ra ki injiri lo ne dem e bi na ko ut ki ta ut chende na vitak wan ke intina ne wan ta fe po sabi rakah ni inah ne antia rak cho san dia da kan changa de sabi ni ko guro rak palas min ko sabi ni ke ni ro rak palas inah ne gawin tu ma do pen ga inah ba ha ni san han he nu pulo or pa indi da wai ra ke bi ino ga na bi pe wa da tan fu anan missing in chem di wet le ina ina weng wo something ne what I in the Seereer Resource Centre Ça fait 6575 mètres. Avec la possibilité d'un d'augmenter l'extension de l'avant. Pour ten biñu wax man nay len wat ñu gor golu dem fi ya gis ten amna ku fi gas ten 13 mètres 14 la wara don fi ngi ma fogg na ku fi gason lo 13 14 be 15 de nga am ndox mu ko ñu doxantu be fara nga ci set ko
dat ya ngi don wax fi ben garab frenelé hein yu ay sérel nga don la
mam
wa ni ni nga wax ci garab yi way sérel nga don la
waaw garab bobu garab balé mam da fay fajj lu bari mom lañ wax auto wolof di wax yetu dem la ko wolof di wax c'est que garab la waxam yi njulli buñu duggé ñalel mom lañ leen defal garab bant mo ñaari bant yoy ñu japp bant yoy boko jappé sétane lu lañu më dem ak yi def lay ragal bu féké né nit ki dem def ko japp yu dem bolé nañ ci liñ ci bolé pour bokk na ci liñu bolé pour ñu fajj ko té liñu wax aussi topum city yaram li génni gom li ki koku daf koy fajj garab mom mam dina fajj gor go xam aussi dafa dem be télé affaire bi dal xawane doole dinañ ko bolé ak lenen pour affaire mu mëna jog bu baax koku yu bari bari dal dinañ ko ku jëri ñoo mom mam
ci buy go wonon
garab bo ma japp no tek ci loxo ba ñu sét dé
And imagine how to call it like a land, because nowadays now people fight over land. They had to call it like they kill each other over land. But in true Seereer culture, we do not fight over land. And there was a saying, an old saying in Seereer culture: if you do not give you the land, we will not fight over it. We will not sell it to you because had to call it, and we're going to leave it behind. And had to call it. The purpose of the land is to respect it. And how to go to honor it and to use it to cultivate food and stuff like that. So just imagine that. I mean, how to call it? He never knew. He didn't know me. I'm not his how to call it, his blood son. I only knew him through Dembasen, and how to call it, he's related to Demba. But imagine that how to call it that what with the value of a land, and especially the size of land in Senegal. How to call it, like, you know, and just want to put this on my hand to say how to call it, you're gonna build how to call it this, and you're gonna, you know, I want you to be responsible for that, how to call it, to put it, how to call it, like, you know, to bring this project to fruition. And that day, it really shook me. And but he was the kind of a generous man, not just with his knowledge and time, but everything, because he understood, he was an Africanist. Because I remember him telling us that this project that he wanted to build, the Temple of Initiated Women, that he wanted in fact, he told us from his own mouth that as many of you know, especially not just the Seereer people have lost a huge chunk of their history and culture. They have lost a huge chunk of their history and culture. Not just the Seereer, but the Senegalese African community, as the African, I include the African diaspora. And he understood this. and he was thinking about the future. He told us article like, you know, I want us to also cater for the African diaspora, because article whose ancestors have suffered through the advent of the Atlantic slave trade and stuff like that, and article as a result they have lost a huge chunk of their history and culture. And bringing this project to fruition, the Temple of Initiated Women, because the Temple of Initiated Women, although it is called the Temple of Initiated Women, it is not hard to call it, like, you know, just for women. It is for everybody. And how to call it, I will explain later why the woman part comes into it. But how to call it, he wanted us to, call it, to cater for also the African diaspora, how to call it, as I was explaining, the people whose ancestors have suffered through the, how to call it, the Atlantic slave trade, and how to call it, who have lost a huge chunk of their history and culture. And he wanted us, how to call it, for them to come down here and also to learn about their history, the traditional African past, the traditional African heritage. So the, how to call it, you know, yeah. So anyway, what I was explaining, that the woman part is how to call it, because as many of you probably know, the serial creation narrative, it was the woman, how to call it, Roxanne, the others, how to call it, the supreme deity Roxanne brought forth it was a woman that came forth, followed by men. And I had to call, like, you know, and also in Seereer, we do value, we are a bilineal society. We respect both the matriclan as well as the patriclan. And I had to call, like, you know, so there are, as many of you know, there are many Seereer matriclans and Seereer patriclans as well. So that's how to call it, how the woman part probably figures in, came in to it. And I always remember his singing, like the one that we did in 2016. I mean, how to call it, I was amazed, and how to call it, all my team were amazed that day. And he always said, how to call it, our ancestors used to preserve their, it was quite common for our ancestors to preserve their history and culture through singing. Anything that is not sung about, be wary of articulate taking it as face value, because articulate in Seereer culture they used to sing articulate historical events so that they will never forget it. So anyway, articulate, like, you know, we after he articulate he showed us this land, and we walked through, it was only a short distance away to Certigibi Prempuista articulate house, where we went there and we spent practically almost the entire day at Satiki Pui's house. And he was so amazing as well. May God, may he rest in, may his soul rest in perfect eternal peace, just like our Professor Thiaw. I will always remember the interviews that I did with him, and especially Hatikoli, the first interview in 2015, the last interview in 2016. And how to call it, in the interview we spent a lot of time discussing, talking about how to call it, the Seereer Heritage, the Seereer Publishing House that I was planning on establishing. And how to call it, now the Seereer Heritage, the Seereer Publishing House, I've been thinking about that since 2008, when I first founded the Seereer Resource Centre, because I thought it would be actually quite useful to how to call it, to ease the workload of the Seereer Resource Centre, and to have an imprint that will, how to call it, be responsible mainly for, how to call it, like, you know, publishing books, history books relating to Senegambian history and culture, and to help out Senegambian authors who are writing about, how to call it, Senegambian history and culture. So, however, how to call it, the workload was too much, how to call it, I say, you know, let me just put this behind, and how to call it, just concentrate on the SRC. However, on that last interview that we did with him in 2016, when, how to call it, like, when he brought up all these things, I said, you know what, in that case, then I have to go back to this publishing, how to call it, objective, this publishing, how to call it, serial publishing, how to call it, venture that I put behind and the back burner for many years. That's what created the article, the Seereer Heritage Press, where we published our last material, Land to Speak Safi Safi, the complete language course, as some of you know. some of you have bought and read, so thank you very much for your support for that. And so I was actually the kind of relationship that I had with him, with Professor Thiaw, was actually like, you know, even if I was in Senegal, however, my journey was too hard to call. I was only there a few days, maybe a day or two. Even if I cannot go down to visit him personally, like I would have liked, would be hard to call. I would call him. This is not just him. There are three people that I would have to call, like that I had a kind of relationship with. That was hard to call: Professor Issa Laye Thiaw, Seereer Radio, and Professor Mara John. Now, even if my trip was so short, and like, for example, I was only in Senegal for a day or two, I would call them and say, you know, Uncle, I've just arrived. However, the journey is too short. I'm only spending a day here or 2 days here. So I would just call to see how you are doing and to let you know that I'm here. Or how to call, I've arrived. Or how to call, the journey is too short for me to come down to personally visit you. But how to call, I was just calling. And that is the kind of respect and relationship that I have with these three people. So that interview in 2016, where he brought out this huge bundle of material, and how to call it, we give us the drive to create the Seereer Heritage Press, Demba and I, in 2018. I was supposed to go back to Senegal to collect that material after that last interview the following year. However, unfortunately, he passed away just months after that interview. It was such a shame, and had to call it like such a loss to not just the Seereer, the Senegambian African community, but had to call to the world, especially to the scholarly world. And on the day of his passing, on the 10th of September 2017, I will never forget that day. I've gathered all my colleagues from the Seereer Resource Centre, from Seereer Radio, and the Seereer Resource Centre already prepared their tribute. And I've gathered all my colleagues from the Seereer Radio, including Dudu Joof, Mumadou Fall, and Kambul Bass, Musukoro Sidibe, and Leyte Sen, and and myself, of course, including Harikuli Demba Sen. Demba Sen was supposed to join we wanted to pay tribute to him the following day, which was the 11th. The day after his passing, wanted to join, but obviously he was representing us there at the funeral, but also he couldn't participate because obviously the internet connection was not very good, was not very clear from Senegal's end, and including, of course, the Radio Defleng Jorbel 96.4. The director, one of the directors was Ali Sen, and also Jokel Damangom. And I had to go we paid tribute to him. And I had to go, that tribute was actually 2 hours long. And I had to go, his passing, we made regular article plate, regular article interviews that we did with him as an additional tribute to the great man. And the same thing that we did for his elder cousin, Saltigibirampui, when he passed away as well. The only thing we can do is to pray for him, and to always remember that he have left behind a family. Just to remember, because you have to remember that he has fought a lot for to bring Seereer history, culture, and spirituality, the spiritual journey of our ancestors, back to the forefront. And I can proudly claim that he have fought for me. And the only thing, if you cannot repay, you can never repay that level of service. But what you can do is to try to make sure since he is not here, that at least whatever you want to do, you do it for his family. He has left the family behind. And we are trying our best. We always liaise with the family, so that they can remember that we have not forgotten them. But just to pray for him, pray for his soul, may his soul rest in eternal peace. including his elder cousin Satigi Birampui. The family they left behind may they be protected and shielded from harm, and may they have an amazing wishing them good luck, so to speak. Because sometimes the way that we pray in Wolof is quite difficult to translate in Hatikoli English, because Hatikoli, English is quite Hatikoli straightforward, but Hatikoli, the way that sometimes they go deep into prayer, but Hatikoli just wishing the family good luck, good health, long life and happiness, and prosperity. And the same for Hatikoli and Satigi Birampui's family. And also praying for Professor Mara Jun. Professor Mara Jun Hatikoli, as many of you probably might know, he was Hatikoli the one who initiated Hatikoli, qualifying the Safi language several decades ago. And also it was through him that I came to know more about this Rampa script, because his late father was very knowledgeable about him. Even Professor Morans from the United States of America, when he went to Senegal in 1980, 81 or 82, he enlisted the services of Professor Mara Jun, who took him to his father so that they can Hatikoli. He started recording it, this Rampa script. So Hatikoli, was praying for Professor Mara Jun as well. May God grant him Hatikoli long life, happiness, and Hatikoli prosperity. And yeah, so Professor Mara Jun, Professor Issa Laye Thiaw was an amazing elder. He was an amazing human being. And Hatikoli, I'd just like to extend my Hatikoli, my tribute to him for everything that he has done and fought and worked for several years in the preservation of Seereer history, culture, and the spiritual path of our ancestors. Because as I always say, you cannot proclaim to love Seereer history and culture, or even African history and culture, yet detest or despise Seereer religion or African spirituality. Seereer spirituality or African spirituality. Because at the spiritual article, our culture and the history comes from the spiritual path of our ancestors. And if you do not believe me, you take a look at ancient Egypt. Now some of you might be one of these Egypt article, I don't know what they call them nowadays, but Hatikoli, invested in Hatikoli trying to make links to ancient Egypt. Yet, and Hatikoli, the civilization that we glorify nowadays is the civilization of the ancient Egyptian. Ancient Egypt, it was actually in Africa. And their civilization, like their temples and stuff that we are glorifying nowadays and elevating to such a high standard, that came from ancient Egyptian spirituality, was an African spirituality. And Hatikoli, you know, the history and the culture is rooted in the African spirituality, and the same for the Seereer spirituality. So you cannot claim to love the history and the culture, yet detest or despise the traditional path, the traditional religion, which the traditional spirituality. I hate using the word religion, but how to call the tradition, although it is quite embedded in my tongue, but how to call, like, you know, you cannot claim to love the history and the culture, yet hate the religion or show no respect for the spiritual. Even if you say, yeah, I'm a Muslim now, or I'm a Christian now, however, I will never say utter a bad word about African spirituality, about any African spirituality, not just Seereer spirituality, but about any African spirituality, because the culture and the history that I claim to love so much comes from that. And I, just to give you a personal example, my late uncle, Elijah Alu Ibrahim Champ Joof, now some of you, especially the Gambians, would know him. He was a highly, how to call it, acclaimed, renowned scholar, historian in Gambia. He passed away at the age of 87, only a few years ago. And I had to call it, I've had lots of discussion and interviews with him. And at no point, even though he was a devout Muslim, at no point he ever had to criticize the religious belief of his ancestors. Because he would tell me particularly straightforward. He said, Tamsier, you know what? I'm a Muslim. I'm a devout Muslim. However, this is what how our ancestors used to pray, and this is how our ancestors used to do things when they were following traditional spiritual life. So obviously, particularly Professor Thiaw understood this. And he understood the importance of preserving, if not for nothing, but preserving the spiritual life, the spirituality of our ancestors. Because he knew if that dies, then we lose a huge chunk. The most important things are the spirituality of our ancestors and the language. Now, if those two die, then obviously we lose a huge chunk of the history and the culture, because the history and the culture come from that. So he understood it, and he tried to. That's why he spent many years trying to safeguard it and ensure that our stories are preserved in the pages of history. And I would like to join my colleagues. And from the Seereer Resource Centre and Seereer Radio and Seereer Heritage Press and everybody else, and to pay a personal tribute to this great man who have done so much for the Seereer community, for the Senegambian community, as well as for the African and African diaspora. And even for those who know him or for those who don't know him, he have really, really fought for you. And my personal thanks to him and to his family. And we haven't forgotten the family and the family that he had left behind, and anytime that they are ready to come to join us so that we can honor what that man was trying to achieve, we are ready and we are willing anytime that suits them. So thank you to everybody who have been so supportive over the years, and especially you, the Seereer community and the Senegambian African and African diaspora community, particularly the African African Americans, who have been very, very, very supportive. I mean, many of you from the United States have been sending us emails since, for many years. Congratulating on telling us how they could offer their services, how they can help, and so forth. And trying to engage and to advance the cause, so to speak. And we are very, very grateful for everything that you have done. And of course, my teams and our listeners out there, who are regular listeners for Seereer Radio. And also just to say, just be careful with this coronavirus, and wishing everyone good health, and just praying for anyone who has caught this virus, may they regain their health and be discharged from hospital, and anyone who have passed on to the spirit world due to this dreadful virus, may their souls rest in perfect peace. And we're praying, offering our prayers and sympathies to the family they left behind. And so just say thank you very much. And Professor Issa Laye Thiaw was an amazing human being. He was a warrior, and a serial warrior, and an African warrior who have fought for us all, and who have tried to preserve many of the things that our ancestors used to honor and respected, include our culture and history, so that we will never forget it and never lose it. And the only thing that we can do is to come together and try to make sure that we all join forces and help bring forward that great project that he wanted to initiate, which is the Temple of Initiated Women, and that is for me the most fitting honor. Because he was thinking about the future. He was a Pan-Africanist, and he was thinking about the future. He was thinking about how important this is, and not just for the Seereer community, but for the African and African diaspora community, and to make sure that project was established. Unfortunately, with these kind of things, you just don't know. And had a good comfort. He was taken from us so soon, but we will never forget him. We will always honor and respect what he has left behind, the great work that he has left behind. Remember that he has authored a couple of books, and also remember that the books that he has published are so little compared to what he hasn't published yet. He has written so many manuscripts which are not even out yet. That's why, Hadikoli, when I saw that, when he brought up the document that few years back, when I went to the interview, I said to him, Hadikoli, Professor Thiaw, the moment these things are published, no Seereer, no Senegambian history or Senegambian will be lost. No Seereer in particular will be lost, because Hadikoli, these are very, very important and they should come out. That's why he said to me, well, I'm depending on you to help me come out. And I promised him, and I will never, I will never go back on that promise. Now, but how long it take me, I will actually have to go, even if I do not do it exactly how I wanted to, I will do some time, some kind of article. I will make sure the article, what I promised him, even half of it or three quarters of it actually comes to fruition. Now, how long it takes me to get there? Because I promised him that, and article, I never break my promise. And article, so he was an amazing man. He was an amazing man and someone I respected and honored. He was a part of the Seereer Resource Centre team, a part of the Seereer Radio team. Some of you know, he was a very, very regular article, a commentator on article, some of our projects, especially the Chesan Seereer program that we established on Seereer Radio a few years back. And the article, so just sending my greetings to everybody else and to his family, and extending my regards to them. And thank you very much. Man la Tamsier Joof yene ngi déclou Seereer Radio bi nak xam ngeen tay open mic la time normally show you open mic la day tout dam te mo ki moko dépassé Mamoudou Fall wonte tay nak man ngeen am tay xam ngeen li to nek yene ngi don déclou suñu di film bi xam ko nay wax ni li ci gëna mbey ma touti please ñay même ñaanal leen lan xolé bi don dégg so ni don nek yene ngi don follow suñu Facebook page bi ak suñu Twitter page bi di nga xam ne li fi nak fani dañ am decc ku nanal mo nan ko xamne ku deugël ko DC ciossani Seereer koku mo gañu ci fan yi ku ñew wax Professor Issa Laye Thiaw su nekk di gën na déklu suñu radio bi ci last year especially ndaw di gën xamne koku indi nañ ko ci radio bi fini yoon ji bari sax dafa mom interview yu bari lo xamne dafa jëm ci mbiri ciossani Seereer histoire Seereer culture Seereer ak traditional religion Seereer lu suñu mam ya nga xamne mom lañ doonon koku indi nañ ko fi yoon gu bari mi waxtaan meñu helam ak ci mbiram ci mbiri lo xamne dafa dappal yépp ci mbiri Seereer fani nak xam ngeene mom fi nak ci nek ñun lu ñu fulu xam ngeene lefi nak lañ koy tessa ku ñew wax Professor Issa Laye Thiaw suñ harit suñ oncle suñ papa mom mo gañu li nak mom ci show bi nak mom daf ma lefi nak lañ koy tessa man nak beruma wante lefi nak lañ koy tessa man tay ñu tra ñu def lefi show bi suñ def ko proper tribute indi suma colleagues yi nga xam nañu di liggey fi ni ci Seereer Radio ak de Seereer Resource Centre pa man bu introduce len demba sen normally nga mu heen nak war mu ngi warana ñew wante xam nañu tra join ci kanam Mamoudou Fall mu ngi ci line bi Moussou Koro ci dibe mu ngi ci line bi ak Doudou Diouf ko gëntam xam ngeen mom tam daf des present fini ak Leyti Sen jang ngeen koy deg mom tam ci ciossane Seereer dañ duga indi suñ wa gaay yi Sénégalais yi ñi nga xamna ñoo nekk ci jokk fi nak en région def la ngi Diorbel xama indi kon Mamoudou Fall mi ñuy wante gaay yi Mamoudou Fall nga def
jërëjëf tam sey ñu ngi lay nuyu di nuyu ñi nekk ci panel bi yépp di nuyu mbokk yi ñuy deglu yépp vraiment di leen jaale Professeur Issa Laye Thiaw comme ni ko waxe tam sir doon na ko xamantene historien la won donc ko xamantene ciossane ak ade Seereer soxal won nako lool mu ci doon dox walam ci liggey di jangal ñi melni ñun kon ñuy ñaan rek ñun ñep ñu konne liggey bobu bu ko defé ade bi ak ciossane bañu reer am sa jereyef
jeureyef Mamoudou Fall xama ini Leyti Sen yaga nañ la déggal Leyti Sen ci mom tam xam ngeen ne ku daan dégg ci ciñ ciossane Seereer programme mi nga xamne mën ñu la indi samedi bu jossi ñaari waxtu ci Angleterre mom daf ci daan mboka kon am indi ci Leyti Sen mi ñuy wante mboka yi Leyti Sen
waaw tam si allo tam si ñu ngi leen di ziar bu baax
Wow. I'm get
des dial bok auditeur yek auditrice yi ñoo mamadou fa na ngeen def ak choono yi ana wa angleterre ñu ngeen di ziar ci ñep di len wax ne inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un ñu fi joggé wax deug yalla bok ni ngeen ko waxé historien la won bo xamanteni wax deug yalla amon na ndariñ lol ci suñu askan amon na ndariñ aussi ci suñu culture diko ñaanal yalla mu xare ko aljana yalla suñu borom yeureum ko te defo ci aljana fi dawsiya
jeureujeuf Leyti Sen jeureujeuf yo tamit ak kon nak nga duggal suñu jigen ji moy musu koro sidi be mu ngi selam mom tamit barama duggal ñom barama indi judi juuf ci musu koro
bu baax di la ñaanal do ke de nak sama collègue yeb nuyu naan le ma ngi len di ziar bu baax di nuyu suñu mbokk auditeur di len jale di len massaw bu baax ci nakar gi ñu bo di professeur Issa comme ni ko Mamadou Fall waxe mu nek historien nek ben théologien bu magama machallah donc di ko ñaanal yalla xari ko aljana gëna kawé donc di ñaan di mako mi gëna yalla may lan xol ko muñ ak machallah ñu bari jangé nañ ci mom ñu bari ma donc di ñaan rek limu inculquer limu jotté inculquer ñu bari lolu law ba suñu mën ko mën ci jang wa amay ziar ñep
jeureujeuf musu koro sidi be jeureujeuf yo tamit ak kon nak man ma duggal suñu gor gi moy Doudou Diouf na nga def
jeureujeuf Tamsier ma ngi fi xana mi kon ñepp waxe rek jale famille bi mais jale itam Senegal tax suñu bari Issa Laye Thiaw nekatul won ko xamantene dafa bokkon ci famille Senegal yepp ko momon tawati na nak Seereer tax ni ko mo defal waxe ak musu koro ligey bi mu def fi daf na walam tek na ñu bari ci yoon rawati na man ni awma chance rencontre ko nak awma chance dajé mom mais ci ay mbindam jangal na ma lu bari sax o taxé ñak nañ tay comme niko Ahmad Ampate ba di waxé tay mom bibliothèque mo lak ñu ñëni ko séré di waxé guy daanu na ndax nit ku mag la won tam sir
jeureujeuf Doudou Diouf jeureujeuf ci wax gu nga wax nonou jeureujeuf fokk na duggal nañ ci director of defleng ci president defleng fofu nonou Ali Sen yang salam bi Ali Sen nga def
Ali da gel man la jokel Ali da
gel okay Ali okay jokel ngom ci defleng mom tammi gaay defleng jokel ngom na nga def waw
waw ci gindigalé sigilen digal sen waji sen professeur bi Issa Laye waju ba yalla ko ye gila yeureum il était vraiment quelqu'un quoi
golen
bibliothèque lakana connais la culture Seereer isna ko je ne connais pas de vue lumière isna ay œuvrem quoi ay œuvrem même amna ben livre ma livre de la femme Seereer
mangla dege wonte yangi kot nonu so yang don kot nonu wonte ñu la no dege tuti ñu la no dege tuti yang don kot tuti wonte ñu la dege
fa nek ma o partage la douleur quoi ñu koy partage nak équipe def la ñep vraiment mettre na trop quoi vraiment un vrai historien dem na donc une bibliothèque a brûlé un géant tombe dalu na mais nak yeb bir yalla nañ ko ñaan rek yalla baral bakkar ak yobuko aljana Ali Sen dafa genn nak li xamna mu ñew ci kanam deeng
baxna jeureujeuf
ñepp ñu li dañ ko ñu li ko xale mu ci jall ñepp ñu koy jalle ñen koy jalle
jeureujeuf
yalla ko ne yeureup yobuko aljana
golen
ku baax
deug la
xam histoire ku mën histoire vraiment lirna ay audio yep ma ko do écouter deglu tay ci sen boss cap bi tay yep mais yu am sens la nit ko melone vraiment jafena wala bi perdre vous avez perdu un homme vraiment de savoir ou am xam 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 lu muy wax xam lu muy def yalla na ko lay yeureum yep arjena ñu ngi ñaan rek jerejeuf
jerejeuf jokkel jerejeuf jokkel jokkel mo ñi wax ñoy gaay yu wa radio Ndefleng ñi nga xamne ñoy nekk Senegal radio Ndefleng Djourbel 96.4 FM fofu nonu Senegal Djourbel jerejeuf ci wax yi nga wax nonu le fi ndax lañ koy tessa Mamadou Fall fu na amuna ben live show bi nga xamne defoon nañ ko fu na man ak yow nak demba sen ou analysis bi nga xamne defoon nañ ko waaw fofu nonu ci garaw ci amna ñu show ba bu nonu yow dudu ji waxna lu am solo si bu mo wax nonu comme indi si lifi nak Amadou Mbaté ba ki nga xamné moy ndanan gogou ndanani africain gogou nonu waxone si lifi nak ne su gori su kilifa africain deye rek fu melni library danuna lakata si Baté Wolof wonte do buga def ba bala ñu def lo do buga Mamadou Fall yow nga introduce show bi ni si si Baté Seereer ko defa ñu ñi wante ci mbokk Seereer yi nga xamna ñu fañe deg ñu wolof Mamadou Fall
Joseph Thompson comme ñu ko waxe rek émission bi tay ya koy présenter wan way man ma ko wara présenter lool nak dafa am lu ko waral moy dama lay japp wara tukki tay su gudi gi donc lo tax dal nga présenter émission bi tay xamna mo duma yag damay duggu ni rek vraiment ñonté mbokk yi jaal len professeur Issa Laye Thiaw yalla xare ko aljanna comme né Tamsier Joof tourna rek émission fay xaye émission spéciale xandone ho ca agletel da xen tafna professeur Issa Laye Thiaw raf professeur Famack raf historien fa andone a dafa ci sanser soxal en trop aljal lega ten mayu dal andana ino gorke wala we nanene nami ki andone tane ko ci sal fe indanwe graf ko andone aje ga solo trop emission am ke num ba nan no haden na ke nan tane def podcast we ni sanga ma Seereer podcast fe num ba nan no emission ke baxna je ga may ko arna tane karone imba ga jangten nan andone nen tan inwe a ñew teru wa ko professeur fa ko comme la itano añaka ñaanam rek akina jana roga tamit asame basil na andone tane wasumen don ken da ref ki andone tane waxtantel xey kon dam not namto ñuxre en andone tane Tamsier Joof
jerejeuf Mamadou Fall jerejeuf mang la girem yow tamit fokuma am silam bi yo jokkel ngom da alisen la gis de o meuna jokkel moko mo am re machine am bina lan jokkel ngom da alisen la hello ko alisen
hello Tamsier
hello Ali
yamay deg
bang la deg touti
wa Tamsier wa yamay deg touti
wa bang la deg go won jokkel sa volume bi rek
wa ming lay deg
wa ying la deg ñu la deg continue
wa 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 mang d'abord mang koy jall li ñu bok man dama len di jale li nga xam ñu ñoko bok
yori jeuf ciir
hmm len
di jale tam ay ngi jale
sigu sa wala wa
di bok ci di bok ko yeen metti duuy
hmm
di xamne ñak nañu nit ku reuy un homme de culture
hmm
une bibliothèque ko xamne bi da naka humanité bu la doon jëri
deug la
ndax bu ñu ay livreum xam histoire rew mi xam na ko wax deug yalla nit ko xamne dal wax deug yalla do nit ko jafé la nit ko nakale remplacer la
hmm
waye yalla nako yalla xar aljana yalla nako fofa gënal fi mu joggé lim fi baye yalla jara def loxom
golen
wax deug yalla itam ñu jara jalal ngi parce que dembu batay tam si yaangi wax ci mom yaangi wax ci mom lu yaangi wax ci mom lu bax lu ne wax yalla rand ko hommage bu doye doy kon itam jara jëf
jerejeuf ali jerejeuf ali sen ari sen a
moy dem do chiffre day wax ci mo lu rafet dagal temba ñaas bu rafet bu baax yi dem kenn gënul la li nga wax ci mo yalla ko yalla fay
amen amen golé jerejeuf ali sen moy xati koy ci ci di directeur ci fofu nonu ci am radio Ndefleng Djourbel Senegal fofu nonu ñu la gërem bu baax yow tewi sa team sa team bi fofu nonu ali sen ñom jokkel nga ma gaay yi sa gaay yi fofu nonu ak liggéey bu baax yi ngeen def fofu nonu ñu leen gërem mom suñ gor gui am demba sen nga xamne mom man ma mom taxaw ci lifim bi yo start lifi ndaka Seereer Radio ak Seereer Resource Centre be tay man ko nek diko xamne sa xamna dafa am problème fofu nonu Senegal musse muñ ta duga muñ te paré won na duga mu ngi won ci line bi taxaw dañu xaar wante bu fo lifi xamna xom na lifi naka dañ koy test lan moy xew fofu nonu wante lifi naka ñu ngi man ko try pour send message pour send mom nañ ko muñ ko meuna duga mom tamit wante obviously nañ toñ xëñ na su nek mu demba sen su nek ya ngi diko lifi nga call ñu baax ka tay joñu ci Skype bi am man la fi nak lañ koy test amna bien nak ay code ci nga xamé né fofu nonu deug li fi nak Professor Issa Laye Thiaw defé nak yo xamné wax nako dal ba meyé nako xam ci li fi yoy la bëgga duga li té amna yoy nak soko déggé nak té li nga xamné da nga soko xalaté soko toggé ci nako soko toggé do ko xalaat won telefin naka soñu dafa mek comme common sense la ñu ko tuba du wax common sense wote su nekk xalaatuloko diga daf la defil daf la confuse dal wote duma bëgg lifin rek moy lifin naka mu amna ben interview ndeysan buñ def nak bu mo sey wax ci lifin naka Seereer ku nekk dem na bëgg xamé ne jangatu dal lifin naka culture am traditional religion am ak yu ak histoire am yu nonu na tok ba di nekk du nekkati Seereer sax dima bëgg def rek dudu juuf moy lifi naka play section bobu nonu ci lifi naka ngeen déggal lu gor gi di wax ci Professor Issa Laye Thiaw ki nga xamné mom lañu play special tribute tay Professor Issa Laye Thiaw ki nga xamné mo gañu ci dimanche gi ni den 10th of September 2017 tay ñu tay li mom live la tay lifi naka lañ koy téss tay la lundi the 11th of September 2017 Professor Issa mungi gañu dimanche gi ni the 10th so anyway ma playel len lifim bi wena film audio bi rek shot audio rek la ngeen dégga gor gi lu mo wax ci fini
Seereer nak bo sété ci deug man nañ wax na du tour ethnie mais tour religion la religion conception la parce que amna groupe Seereer yu bari mak demba sapen lañu wax amna ko xamne non lay wax am ko xamne ndut lay wax am ko palor lay wax am ko xamne sin nga ndum wala sin lay wax way yoyu yeb ño bokk ni ñuy touro ño bokk ni ñuy ñaan yalla ño bokk ni ñuy bey agriculture ñoko bokk ño bokk ni ñuy sam sen samo ben samin la moko bokale bon nga senne bon Seereer du langue wi rek mais des pratiques et des croyances rituelles moy Seereer et Seereer bes bu baye pratique bo rek baye tradition baye religion traditionnelle da fay ñak lepp presque day dem be dotu nek Seereer wa
ngi ma tam Seereer Diouf yam Seereer rajam ngi ma Diouf yam tam Seereer Diouf borom angal tier musa yo yaale jam borom angal tier musa yo yaale jam ngim yo tam Seereer Diouf waynaale yaale jam Seereer rajo yo waynaale wa yaale jam ngim yo jokel ngom ngi wa ngom mendu piyande jokel anjare ngi ma ngom yaale jam layam ki man wallana ngom sahara yam ki mana Seereer rajo yo yaale jam
wagan xanit wagan wagan kumba sanjan tindandang dange o Seereer rajo tsan o Seereer maringone xey simnanum maringone kanyitu fay biram pendo wagan dugu dugu wagan xanit wagan wagan kumba sanjan fay bo fet fay jam diko is na jam